Tech Widget here, and I'm here to solve all your lag problems. So have you been in a Fortnite game where you've died because of major lag? Well, I'm here to fix that. So in today's video, I'm going to be covering some topics, and those topics include lowering your ping, getting better FPS, and overall just having a smoother Fortnite experience. So let's get right to it. Into this, we have is internet connection. This is a major one. So I average around 0 to 30 ping because I live in Georgia, which is a city that I live in is 600 miles away from Virginia, where the Fortnite servers are located at. So I'm going to have a tough time getting some low ping. Anyway, so you can really reduce your ping even if you have a bad server connection. So first, you really want to check if you're on auto or an NA East or whatever. So you want to check if what server is nearest to you. So once you have determined that, you want to connect to that server connection. It's going to be in your Fortnite settings. It's very easy to change. But then this is the most important thing that you want to focus on: if you have a wired connection versus a wireless connection. So a wired connection is like an Ethernet cable that you plug from your router to your PlayStation. So what I find is really easy: you can get like a 100-foot Ethernet cable, and you can just route it through like carpet or whatever you need to the router room or whatever. If it's right beside your PS4, you're lucky, you can just plug it into that, you're set. But you also want to look at if you have a monitor or a TV. A monitor will do really good, because if you have most of the monitors are 60 hertz, which means the game boosts out 60 fps, your monitor is going to show 60 fps. But if you have a TV, you're going to get an input delay. So that basically means if you tap a button on your controller, it is going to take a couple seconds for it to show up on your TV. That might not be long, but you can definitely feel it when you're playing Fortnite. But so if you're on like a newer TV, you're going to have a gaming mode, so you want to check if your TV has that. But for the monitor, it's basically just connecting it and seeing if it has 60 hertz, which it probably does. Most monitors do. So let's go on to number 4. You can go onto your Fortnite settings, and you can change where you can turn off replay mode, because that will multitask your PS4 and it will overheat and it will not do good. And you want to delete the clips, Fortnite clips, or whatever storage that you don't need on your PS4. So if you have an option to wire your controller, definitely do that. So on the PlayStation, you can connect your controller to your PS4. You definitely want to do that, because that sends the signal right to it, back and forth. It is going to be the best thing, for mostly one of the best things that you can do. So, and if you have a mouse or whatever, you want to make sure you get a wired one. That will lower your input delay by a ton. So really, that is all you can really do. And guys, overall, just remember that you don't want to multitask on your Wi-Fi. So if you have your TV on, like on YouTube or something, and then you're playing Fortnite, just go turn it off, guys. So really, you don't need to do too much. So it can also depend on the performance of your internet connection and stuff like that. But peace out. See you.